Okay, we are starting with the questions based on empirical formula. Find the empirical formula of the following compounds which contained 3.22 grams of Na, 4.48 grams of S, that is sulfur, and 3.36 grams of oxygen. Now here we are supposed to find the empirical formula. Empirical formula, as you have seen in the previous class, is empirical formula is the smallest whole number ratio that a compound can have. Okay, now here we are taking first here the masses. Okay, that is Na, S, and O. I'm going to write in this order. Okay, Na the mass is 3.22 grams. Then S the mass is 4.48 grams. And oxygen the mass is 3.36 grams. Okay, now this is the masses that are given that a compound is having. Now we are going to calculate over here the moles. These moles will be calculated by dividing these masses by their respective atomic masses. So these are the masses that are there of these three elements. This is going to be getting divided by the respective atomic mass. From the periodic table, the atomic mass of Na is 23. Sulfur, the atomic mass, relative atomic mass is 32. And oxygen, the relative atomic mass is 16. So I'm going to carry out the division for all of this. Okay, I'm going to use the calculator over here. So this is going to be 3.22 divided by 23. This gives me the value 0.14. The next value that we are calculating is this 4.48 divided by 32. This gives me the value of 0.14. The third value that we are going to calculate is for oxygen, which is 3.36 divided by 16. Which gives me 0.21. I have got the moles of all three of this. The next step that we are supposed to do is, in order to get the whole number ratio, what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide all these values by the smallest value. 0.14, 0.14, 0.21. The smallest value of these three is 0.14. I'm going to divide all three of them by 0.14. This is going to become 1. This also is going to become 1. 0.21 divided by 0.14 is 1.5. Now this is not a number like either 1.1 or 1.9 which you can round it off. So here what you are going to do in order to convert this into a whole number, I'm going to multiply this by 2. So 1 into 2 is 2. 1 into 2 again over here is 2. 1.5 multiplied by 2 is 3. Okay. So Na, S and O are in the ratio 2, 2 and 3. So the empirical formula of this compound that we are going to get is going to be Na2, S2. You're going to take down this sum. If you have any questions or difficulties, you can ask me. Okay, so these are the next kind of questions that are there for practice.
So can I try this?
No. Calculate the empirical formula and molecular formula for the following. I'm recording, so just stay quiet. You can ask me all your questions afterwards. Okay, now the percentage of carbon is given, the percentage of hydrogen is given. From this, you will be able to calculate the molecular formula. The procedure and steps are simple. Whatever the percentage is given in order to get the number of moles, we are going to divide it by its atomic mass. Atomic mass of carbon is 12. Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. Okay, you get whatever the numbers are there, divide by the smallest number. You are going to get this ratio as 1:2.5. Once you get this number 1:2.5, I'm going to multiply this by 2 in order to convert it into a whole number. So this is going to become 2 and this is going to become 5. So in the empirical formula that you are going to get is C2H5. This is the empirical formula because the ratio of carbon is to hydrogen is 2:5. Now you got the empirical formula. Now the second thing that is asked over here is calculate the molecular formula when the RMM, that is relative molecular mass or simply molecular mass, is given. Now to calculate the molecular formula, what we are going to do is we will calculate empirical formula mass. So C2H5, carbon atomic mass is 12 plus 5 hydrogen atoms are there, atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. This is equal to 2 into 12 is 24 plus 5, this is 29. I'm repeating what I have done over here. We got the empirical formula by following these steps. Divide by the atomic mass, you get a particular number. Smallest number you divide, you get this ratio, convert this into whole number. We are getting empirical formula as C2H5. Now you calculate the empirical formula mass as we are calculating molecular mass. So C2H5, carbon atomic mass is 12. So 2 into 12. Hydrogen, 5 atoms of hydrogen are there. Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. You calculate the empirical formula mass, which is 29. Now, 29, how many times will give me 58? That is the molecular mass. 29 multiplied by 2 is 58. So this empirical formula which is there, in order to get the molecular formula, okay, 29 is multiplied by 2, so you get the relative molecular mass. So to get the molecular formula, this empirical formula will be multiplied by 2. So your molecular formula is going to become C4H10. This will be the molecular. Now if you have any questions, you can ask me. The next term which is there also, you are supposed to do it in the same way, which is this one. You'll get the empirical formula first. Once you've got the empirical formula, you are going to calculate the empirical formula mass by substituting the values of atomic masses, and then how many times it is equal to the molecular mass. You multiply that number and that's going to give you the molecular formula. You can copy down this part. You'll do the second part and send it to me. You have to finish all these parts, Yash, and you have to send it.